My name is Sherman Owen. I'm with Artisan Resources LLC. I'm a brewing and distilling consultant. I've been working in this field now for 4 years. Today I would like to show you a demonstration of some enzymes that have become available to me. I buy these in large quantities and break them down into smaller containers, so I thought everyone would like to see what can these enzymes do. The first enzyme I'd like to show you is the Sebstar. The Sebstar is a high-temperature alpha amylase. This will work up to 195 degrees Fahrenheit and has the capability of breaking starch that's been gelatinized down into dextrins. The dextrins are made available to the other enzyme. This is a glucoamylase, and the difference between a beta amylase and a glucoamylase is the fact that not only can this dissolve the 1,4 bonds for the starch, it can also do the 1,6 bonds for the starch, which means it can take the complex sugars and break them down into simpler sugars, mainly glucose. The plan today is to mash 15 pounds of grain, and I would like to have a liquid yield of 10 gallons. Since the grain itself absorbs about a pound, about a tenth of a gallon for each pound of grain, I'm going to add an additional gallon and a half, so that gives me a total of 11 and a half gallons for the whole mash. And into this 11 and a half gallons, I'm going to put 15 gallons of corn. Now, typically, this would be very difficult to do without a lot of extra equipment due to the fact that once it gels, it's like moving pudding. So what I'm going to do is add the alpha amylase while the corn's still cold. I'm also going to put the corn into the water while it's cold to prevent any dough balls from happening. And then I'm going to bring it up to 190 degrees, and I'm going to hold it 190 degrees for about an hour and a half. After that hour and a half has passed, then I'm going to cool it down to 150 degrees. At the 150 degrees, I'm going to acidify it a little bit because the glucoamylase likes a little bit less pH. I'm going to try to get it down to about the 5-4 range, so that means I'll be adding citric acid, and then adding the glucoamylase. Now what the glucoamylase is going to do is going to take this very thin liquid starch that's been turned into dextrin, and it's going to create lots of sugar out of it. So that's what we're hoping the end result. Once I get the temperature down to about less than 100 degrees, then I'll be adding some yeast to make sure that it'll ferment. Okay, before we get started, let me explain what I've got set up here. First of all, I've got a stainless steel bucket that holds about 17 gallons. Right now, I've got very cold water in there, around 50 degrees Fahrenheit, and I've got 11 and a half gallons of it. Over here, I've got a thermometer set up that's adjustable in height, so in case the level changes too much, I'll be able to adjust it. Here I have my mixer motor. You see it's just a half inch DeWalt drill, and it's connected to a stainless steel rod, and the stainless steel rod has a somewhat homemade propeller on the end of it. This is quite enough to mix this amount of volume without any issues. The drill is on a homemade stand that gives it lots of stability, and that will allow me to be able to do everything hands-free. Also, on the wall, I have a magnetic thermometer, and the thermometer can give me the temperature that I'm needing whenever I need it, so that I'll be able to do this program quite well without having too many issues as far as temperature concerned. This will cause me to have to modulate the temperature up and down, but that won't be any issue. And that's the setup that I'm going to be using today. Thank you.
Okay, now the corn is all in. I'll be adding the first enzyme to it. Sorry for all the noise, but sometimes it's a noisy business. So I've got the fresh char that I'll be adding. Our temperature has already come up 14 degrees, so this should go fairly quick. I'm going to do a pH test to see if we need to adjust the pH for the alpha amylase or not. This is an easy read indicator until I've had it for a while. So what I'll be doing is using this throughout this demonstration. It looks to me like it's showing somewhere between the 5.0 and the 6.0, so I believe I'm going to say that it's in the right ballpark. We're now at 150 degrees. This is generally where the corn starts thickening up. Let's check its progress a little bit. As you can see, it's still nice and thin. I'll show you another picture when we get to about 165. All right, now we've reached 165. We're above the temperature that corn starts gelatinizing. You'll notice a lot of difference in the look. All right, now you can see that it's starting to get more clear, very shiny looking. That's due to the dextrin being released into the mash, but also, this is where it would usually start seizing up with this much corn. It's still moving quite well. We're now above 180 degrees. This is normally where most people would say that you couldn't go much higher due to the fact that the start stem has already fouled the heat exchanger. Well, I'm doing direct heat from the bottom of this, and it just still keeps on going. So let me show you what this looks like. It's a little difficult to focus because it's very hot and there's lots of steam coming off of it. But as you can see, it made the transition all the way through the temperature range of gelatinization corn starch, and it's already above that. And it's still moving as if it were like water. I can say that this enzyme is a very productive enzyme. All right, as you can see, we've made it to 190 degrees. The stuff is still moving as if I've never added any corn to it. I've got the flame set at just the very smallest flame to help maintain a little bit of the heat, and you can see it's already starting to drop. I'm going to do a starch test here in a moment. Okay, now the iodine test. As you can see from it turning black, we've still got quite a lot of starch in there. So we're going to have to let it set for a while and maintain the temperature.
Okay, we've been at 190 degrees in around there for quite a long time now. I'd say somewhere around maybe an hour. So I wanted to show you the viscosity of this without the agitator running. As you can see, it's just absolutely liquid. There's still a little bit of corn in suspension, and also while we're here we can go ahead and do a starch test. Now, you know, if we have any starch left in this, it turns the iodine absolutely bluish purple, and it stays that way. Okay, we initially get a little bit of blue purple, but because it's mostly dextrin now, it fades. And it should just leave us with kind of a light brown color. Since this cools quite a lot faster with the agitator running, I'm going to turn the agitator back on.
It doesn't take very long with the drill running because as you see it blows air into the mask. We're going to go ahead and drop it down to 150 now, and then we'll check the pH once it gets near 150. And if we need to decrease the pH the more we will. We need to get the pH below 5.4. As you can see, the air blowing from the grill, a lot of air blowing, it tends to cool the mash pretty quick. We're down to 150 degrees now. Now we need to do a pH test, see if we need to adjust the pH before we add the other enzymes. Still indicating orange, which means we probably need to add just a little bit of acid. I'm going to be mixing up and adding some citric acid. Alright, I have just a small amount of pre-mixed citric acid. I'm going to add that to the wash and give that time to stir a moment, then we'll test the pH. I have two ranges of pH strips here to measure this. I would like to get a little more accurate than just using the liquid. So I'm going to get both of them a dump real quick, and we'll check. It appears we're in the 4-6 range. See, the blue one got brighter blue, but the yellow one is somewhere between the yellow and the light brown. So I believe we're somewhere around 4-8, which is very good for our glucoamylase. I'd like to do a start test again, just to see if we've had any additional conversion. Usually about 3 drops of this is all it takes. Kind of difficult to do from this type of dropper. But if there's any starch in it, it will remain black. If it's no starch, it will fade to almost colorless. So you see we have almost no starch left. It's just a brown, which usually indicates dextrin. Alright, our pH is in the correct range, and our temperature is where the temperature needs to be to add our glucoamylase. So I'm going to add the glucoamylase now. Now we'll sit and wait for our conversion to go. I'll keep cycling the heat if I need to. I'm going to try to let this run at about 150 degrees for an hour. Okay, we've had this cooking now for an hour. From the viscosity and everything, it looks like it's quite done. You'll see I've lost some liquid level. I had to lower the temperature flow to keep up with it. So I'm going to take a small sample and then we're going to give it a test. I've got a sample that's still pretty warm, but I want to see if it tastes like this cane sugar. Yes, it's quite sweet. It tastes almost like sucrose. It doesn't have a high fructose corn syrup taste to it, or even a table syrup taste. It does taste very much like sucrose. I'm always amazed at how sweet this is for you. Quite good. So I believe I'm going to put a wort chiller in it, let it start cooling down, and then I'll take some of it and take a sample and get you an original gravity reading. I'm using a wort chiller so I can bring the temperature down quickly.
Okay, I've got a hydrometer reading for you now. I used an ice bath to bring this down to 60 degrees so that you could see the real reading rather than apparent reading or have to adjust for temperature. And you can see we've got a gravity of 1060. 60 points off of that is just about what's expected if you get a really good thorough conversion. I've moved it in here to my office. It's well below 100 degrees. I pitched the yeast, and as you can see, all of the solids and the nice liquid are all starting to separate very, very well. And it's very interesting when it does that. It always gets this turtle shell effect. Well, this is Sherman, and I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a pleasure of mine showing you mashing with enzymes. I hope everyone learned something, and these will be on sale soon at www.artisanresources.com. I intend to put the initial price about $14.95 for a pair of 100 milliliter containers of each of the enzyme. And that way you can have enough to convert somewhere between 150 and 200 pounds of corn. Thank you much.